Hey guys, welcome back. Today's a bit of a longer video. Today we're going to be working on black gel coat, specifically a cobalt. We're going to take it through all of its steps. Wait for it.
The worst is this oxidation. It's a black boat, or at least it's supposed to be. And if you know cobalts, they have an additive that they put in their gel coat that makes it a little bit harder. So it's a little bit more glass-like than plastic-like. When you see this, you can either get into wet sanding, which I don't have a problem with. If you're a good wet sander, go ahead and wet sand. But as a detailer who has to get this done in less than a day, I'm gonna use another version of wet sand, and that is Super Duty. It's wet and it's gritty, because sand. So Super Duty on this, I'm just gonna go probably the top to here. I'm not gonna worry about the white and the bottom for this demonstration. I'm even gonna pull out these little scuffs here with the Super Duty. I'm not gonna hit them with acetone or lacquer thinner or anything else, just Super Duty. So if you don't mind, I'm gonna get into that. To start with, I use a double-sided wool pad. Now, 3M pads, while expensive and sometimes a little bit wobbly, are the most aggressive cutting pads that I have found out of all of the wool pads I've ever used. So I use them. I don't get sponsored by 3M. I also use their Quick Connect. Still, I'm not sponsored, but it seems like it does save a little bit of time when you're doing this all day. If you're not doing it all day, just get a spindle nut, double-sided pad. You can flip it over, spin it back on. You're not gonna lose a lot of time. So for this, I'm gonna use a ton of Super Duty, all right? And I'll try my best not to cover what I'm doing with my back. I'll leave a little section so that you can see the difference. I'm just gonna spread this out, make sure to cover everything that I can. Now, once I've got this spread out, there are some chemicals in here that help break down gel coat and soften it up a little bit. I don't, however, want it to dry, but I work it while it's wet. So I work my edges first. This is an edge, this is an edge. I'll show you how that goes. For all you people out there that think that I'm not effectively taking off any gel coat or any oxidation, this black color might dissuade you from that way of thinking. I assure you, there's a little bit of pressure used here. I'm doing a little bit of a cross cut, going back and forth, focusing only on this and this edge. That's all I care about. The fact that it cuts this a little bit, that's an added bonus, but it's not why I'm doing it. I'm only focused right here and right here. All right, so my next edge is down here. Now, for bottom edges, I work it a little bit different. I basically find a position that I like where I'm getting a good amount of cut or an aggressive polish pass, and I try to lock my body position and the buffer position so that I can just mimic that the entire way through, and it looks a little something like this. So if you're seeing some color, there actually is a reflection there just from Super Duty. And again, a little bit of boat comes off. We're getting through the oxidation, revealing generally some fairly clean, unoxidized gel coat. I'm sure there's still oxidation in there. Don't worry, we got two more passes to go through. For the middle, I like to do what I call cross-cutting. Cross-cutting is literally just that. There's patterns going like this. Now there's patterns going like this. It's crossing. Okay? Now, you might notice I didn't go all the way down to the bottom, nor did I go all the way to the top. Why? Because I've already hit those. So if you guys have a problem getting your finishes perfectly smooth without any swirls, but up here and down here you get some little holograms and some artifacts, I don't. There's a reason for it. Now, here I went up and down. You can also go side to side. Alright, now once I've done that fairly aggressively, look at that. I know, it's redundant. Now I go flat. And in this case, just to save some time, not much, but some time, I'm going to speed up a little bit. And put a little bit of pressure on the bolt. Not much. And now, much less pressure. Now, if you're seeing a reflection, it's because there's a reflection. Super Duty can actually leave a reflection. And before I fluff up the rest of the pad, there's a little bit of gel coat in there. So the aggressive cutting, the going flat, it all takes off a little bit of oxidation. You could stop right here, but for demonstration purposes, I'm going to keep going so that I can show you maybe, fingers crossed, that this can actually finish almost swirl-free with Super Duty. I should also add, because this stuff's bad for you, you should be wearing eye protection, ear protection, mouth and lung protection. And if you're wondering why I only use 3M products, it's because they're consistent. And no, they don't sponsor me. I'm not supported by 3M at all. I do occasionally give them a call and talk to some people, let them know what I think and what questions I might have. But I don't use their products for anything other than the fact that they're consistent. And when you're doing maybe 20 boats a month, you kind of want some consistency. What do you think? You can almost read my watch just from that reflection. Coming from this, guys. Huh? All right, so the next step, yuck. The next step is a little bit of heavy cut. And I'll show you what that looks like. Now it's time for 3M's heavy cut. This is also just gonna go in the pad. And you might be surprised to find out I'm gonna do the exact same things that we did with Super Duty with the heavy cut. And then a slow walk down on the bottom. And then some cross cutting. Thank you. For the record, much less boat came off, but still, a little bit came off. And I should be able to see what time it shows on my watch. And this is from heavy cut. We got one more step to go, and that's perfected EXAC. All right, so I've cleaned out the pad, took a little spur and just ran it across there. It's just a fluffy, soft. And we're gonna use, oh, focus. Some 3M's perfected EXAC 36060. Same basic stuff. A little bit goes directly on the pad and spread it out. I'm going to turn the light on. Ta-da! Right. Now at least you can see what it looks like once it starts to finish up. Bottom section. And some cross-cutting. Thank you. Glossy on there. See what this looks like. You alright?
Yeah,
you talking to a crow? I guess. Your spirit animal. You can wet sand this, I suppose, if you want to. Which, again, I don't have a problem if you want to wet sand it. You're just not going to get me to do it because I got other things to do. There you go. Ta-da! Put a little wax on that. Should look great. And this is a big fluorescent light, so it's not going to look as good as it would maybe out in direct sunlight. In another section, I want to point out there are some pretty deep scratches in this hole. You might not be able to see them in two dimensions, but trust me, they're there. There's also quite a bit of rub marks, just some transfers from, I don't know, hitting something made of plastic. I'm going to get those out without using acetone or lacquer thinner or anything like that. So I will set you up right about here. Turn the camera up a little bit. And maybe to the right, just a smidge. How's that? Isn't that good? Okay, so I got my spur. I've already cleaned out the pad. We got a light. Just gonna do the same things I did before without very much of the commentary. So here we go. I'm using quite a bit of Super Duty, as you can see. And I'll be blending in what we worked on before to this section here. Way too fast.
Yikes.
Thank you. little bit of hop. In one of the last videos, I showed you that to remove the hop, changes the speed, changes the frequency. Here's another way I sometimes get rid of it. I just change the way I hold the buffer. So I've cleaned it up. You can actually see all the little scratches right in there. So now the trick's gonna be get those out. And I'll show you how I do that. Fingers crossed.
Thank you.
What's that? Switching to the clean side, grab a little heavy cut, which, oh my gosh, conveniently,
Herbert has.
Luckily, he has two bottles.
One for you, one for me.
You want some?
No, you got some.
Oh,
good.
Yeah, go ahead. And then right where these little scratches are, I'm going to do a little extra work up on a fairly aggressive edge. And then just regular cross cuts. Thank you. next step is a little perfected EXAC. My job now is to blend everything from here over to here. So that's what I'll do. Okay, I got a little perfected EXAC on the pad. And because we kind of crossed over into the second section that we did, I'm gonna go ahead and cover that a little bit. So this is gonna be a big section.
And yeah, that's my buffer making a little bit of noise, but she was made in 2017, and if you put your girl through as much work as I put mine through, you just kind of forgive a little bit of noise and lip. I do. She's still putting out good work, and I wouldn't give her up for a brand new one right now if you offered me one. By the way, DeWalt, it's pretty much time for you to offer me like a pallet full, don't you think?
last final step. I know, it looks a little swirly, but my guess is these will all wipe off.
Wally,
you're an old guy.
Even you surprise yourself. I would have done better, given time, obviously.
It all looks good. It all looks good.
Let's be honest, not everyone can do a good job. I can do it.
Yeah, you can. You've done amazing jobs.
You just gotta have patience. I just wanted to hear that I could do a good job. I work here.
So that, from that, it's possible. You don't have to wet sand. And I promise you, if you put a wax on this after you clean it, that finish is going to last for at least a year. And if you keep maintaining your boat and put a new wax on it before it starts to fade, you can probably keep this going for years, plural. All right, get out of our face. We got work to do.
Get out of our face. We got work to do, guys. Come on. Peace out.
Well, that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. If you'd like, give a thumbs up. Go ahead and subscribe. Tell a friend. Seriously. Tell 3M. Tell DeWalt. Put me on Facebook. Do all that stuff. But mostly, thanks for having fun with us.